An alarming 1 in 10 high schoolers will attempt suicide. That's a dramatic increase over the past decade, and that's why Upstate University Hospital is about to take a big step forward in fixing a problem plaguing not only Central New York, but the country.
And to that end, next week, a new unit will open dedicated to teens at risk of hurting themselves. This Channel 9's Andrew Donovan, who's followed this story for years, takes us inside.
The hallway looks pretty ordinary, but the rooms and the treatment that will happen inside them are shockingly hard to come by.
How quickly do you expect all this to fill up?
You know, we already have three or four people waiting down in the emergency room for this unit to open.
Wow.
I think that we'll probably fill it within the first 2 days.
As soon as these eight rooms open, Dr. Chris Lucas will already be building a waiting list of children ages 12 to 17 who either just hurt themselves or threatened to.
This reminds me more of a dorm room than a hospital room.
Mm-hmm.
It's meant for a longer stay. There's shelving, there's a desk, private bathroom. Why is that?
You know, we don't want it to feel like a prison. We want it to feel as if this is a place where they can make a new start.
Rooms that are long overdue, with nearby Hutchings constantly full, even tonight, the only options for a child in a similar crisis are at hospitals hours away, or in a bed wherever Upstate has room, but isn't designed for the mental health care they need. Not ideal for the patient, and not ideal for other patients who need that bed. 3 years ago, we introduced you to Gina Butler, a mom from Oneida, upset when her son's long-awaited cleft palate repair was canceled the night before.
We know this decision can be disappointing for families, but it is made in the best interest of all patients.
We had a day when we had 30 children in Golisano Children's Hospital, either in the emergency department or the pediatric floors, waiting for psychiatric placement.
This morning's ribbon cutting is part celebration, but part recognition that more rooms and more work is needed to stem the crisis. In Syracuse, Andrew Donovan, News Channel 9.
And we're told patients will stay admitted between a few days and a few weeks and be taught skills to better tolerate stressful situations and advocate for their own mental well-being using what doctors call a proven program.